Democrat Senator Joe Manchin might not be running for Senate again, but he doesn't mean he's done with politics. According to a new report, the senator from West Virginia has created a new centrist organization that's looking to remake politics, which really just means looking out for corporate interests. Now, it's interesting. You and I have done stories on this organization for how many years? 10 years?
Yeah.
They've been out there kind of kicking around 10 or 20 years. No labels. Talk about it.
Yeah, no labels, which basically just means we're a corporate front group pretending to be a political party. Yeah. And Joe Manchin has always, you know, flirted with no labels. And right now, he's flirting with them to the point where there is huge speculation he's going to run for president under their banner.
What's he doing, but, American Together?
Americans Together. That is the dark money group. It's registered to where they don't have to reveal their corporate donors, and it's funneling a ton of money into no labels. Mm-hmm. But, you know, technically, Joe Manchin, his name is not on the organization. What it is his daughter, the former pharma CEO, Heather Bresch. And Bresch is the one who, when she took over Mylan, jacked up the prices on all the EpiPens. You know,
was it 2,000%? I mean,
I was paying $1,200 twice a year for a single EpiPen for my children.
Yeah.
And so, to me, whenever I talk about Heather Bresch, it is very personal because I lost thousands of dollars every year. Yeah. Because of Heather Bresch.
A lot of people did. And the point is this, again, all right, well, he's an important politician. Corporate media barely covered the story. You had to hunt the story. Really, you had to hunt for the story. Yeah. But the point is, no labels, just so you understand, and viewers understand, no labels is just centrist, blue dog Democrats that care nothing more than about how does Wall Street do.
Yeah.
That's what it is. And it could be a real deal. People they might not like him all over the country, but the South likes Manchin.
Yeah, they do.
And conservative areas in this country like Manchin. He's very good on his feet. He's a threat.
He really is. And up to about a year ago, he was actually the fifth most popular senator in their home state.
Really, wow.
So even West Virginia loved him. And it's not because, oh, he did all this stuff for us. It's because he did nothing. Because that's what no labels is all about.
Doing nothing.
Yeah, it's not about we've got to make the lives of these people better. It's no, we maintain the status quo because the status quo works wonderfully for these corporations.
It's like the last story we just did. Don't prosecute these criminals when they kill people. Because they're dressed up in suits and they have MBAs from Harvard and Yale. That is no labels, you see. That is the same thing that this Justice Department is doing. They will love Joe Manchin. And I got to tell you something, if he gets out there, this 501c4, people understand, they don't understand how dangerous that is. There's no way to even know where the money comes from. I mean, it's just dark, dark money. And it was made possible by Citizens United, of course. And so he, what is it? They raised 20, no labels raised $20 million in the last year. Just a lot of money. They're becoming a real entity. And now this might be the first face of a presidential run.
Yeah, and look, you know, right now there is a lot of hunger in this country for a third party candidate. We see that in the polls. Mm-hmm. And so if people don't know what no labels is, obviously the name sounds attractive. Like, hey, I'm sick of Democrats, I'm sick of Republicans, no labels. Well, that just sounds wonderful. Yeah. But no, best way I could describe it, you know, in my opinion, would be this is essentially
Republican.
It's a corporate front group, in my opinion. Yeah. I mean, that's what they do. They act in the interest of corporations. It's not about bringing together the left and the right.
Well, as a matter of fact, corporate America put it together. You understand, the Goldman Sachs folks, those people put all of this together. And it's emerging. I mean, it's going to emerge this time. And truthfully, Joe Biden is an easy takedown.
Well, and especially, you know, you throw suddenly Joe Manchin into the mix. Yeah. You got Bobby Kennedy, whose polls are really well since he switched to independent. Cornel West. Next year could be just chaos in the presidential race, and maybe we need a little chaos. Well,
I think we do. I think we need that kind of chaos. I love that we have other parties. I wish we had something besides the No Labels Party.
And yeah.
But, you know, if somebody's looking down a voting, I mean, they're at the polls. They're looking down a list. Biden, Trump will be in there, I predict. Then you go below that, who shows up next? Does Manchin? Oh, I kind of like Manchin. Don't know much about him, but he's got this new party. Bobby Kennedy, I don't know a lot about him, but I do know he's good on the environment. People have that tendency. Because they don't have, I mean, we take it for granted that everybody has as much information as we have. We do this every day.
Yeah.
The average American is very difficult for them to keep up with this. I mean, you know, they got to go to work. They got to make house payments. They can't keep up with this kind of thing. So it's almost a temporal kind of reaction there, you know. This is a third party. Maybe it's time for a shakeup. And Joe Biden is easy pickings in that regard.